This is JP from Know the Lights Over Arkham. This time I will be playing the Into Deep scenario from the Innsmouth Conspiracy expansion. I am continuing my first playthrough with Sister Mary. So far, Sister Mary hasn't had an easy way through the campaign. So in the first scenario, Sister Mary got defeated and got one physical trauma. In the second scenario, we were able to find out the location of the kidnapper's hideout, but we didn't get there in time to save Agent Harper. So we had to resign, and we managed to get 2 experience from that scenario. So let's see what I upgraded into Sister Mary's deck. The only upgrade is the Sacred Covenant that came in the Into Deep Mythos pack. It's a real good card for Sister Mary, as sometimes you don't want to spend the Bless tokens you reveal during a skill test, so you can just, if your modifier is high enough, just put them back into the bag by using the Sacred Covenant. So I upgraded that into the deck. Otherwise the deck remains the same, so that is enough of that. In the last 2 playthroughs I read all of the story text, but that is taking so much time in these videos, so I decided to just shorten what's happening. So in short, after last scenario, Sister Mary comes through and Sister Mary and Agent Harper head down into the village of Innsmouth, and they witness an invasion of these creatures coming from the sea. So I think that is enough what's happening, and Agent Harper tells us that we need to get to the railway station where they park the cars. So we need to get through this map to the other side. We are starting at the desolate coastline, so let's see if Sister Mary can make it to the other side of the map. So let's get started. I have pre-shuffled the deck, so let's draw our opening hand. So we get Olive McBride, Clairvoyance, Promise of Power, Ward of Radiance, and Drawn to the Flame. I think we keep Olive McBride and Clairvoyance, and we'll shuffle the rest, or mulligan the rest. Let's see, we get Swarcane, we get the Blessed Blade, and Sixth Sense. Okay, so I think my starting play will be to play down Olive McBride and Sixth Sense and try to start investigating and then build up enough resources to play the weapons. And I think Clairvoyance won't be played. I doubt there are that many locations with double clues here. Okay, let's see. I still need to put resources down. So first action, I'll just play Olive McBride. Second action, I'll play Sixth Sense. And oh yeah, and at the start of the during the setup, we need to add 2 Bless tokens to the back. Also, if you've been following my previous playthroughs, I messed up that you actually reset the chaos pack between scenarios. So in the last scenario, I made it way too difficult for myself, and I had all of the curse tokens in the back. So we are starting with no curse or bless tokens in the back, but Sister Mary adds 2. Also, there are 6 key tokens here, which are randomized. During the setup, we placed 1 key token onto the hideout, which was in the Esoteric Order of Dagon. And these represent the resource tokens that are placed to be barriers, so we can't move in between locations with barriers there. And we have an action on the act card, which is a fast triggered ability. Spend 1 clue per investigator plus 1 clues as a group. Remove 1 barrier between locations and a connect your location and a connecting location. And objective is get to the railroad station. If each surviving investigator has resigned advance, then if we are at the fully flooded location, we take 1 damage at the end of the turn. We don't need to worry about the suspect enemies because we didn't defeat any in the last scenario. These locations start as partially flooded. So the last action I'll spend, I'll use Olive and use the sixth sense to investigate. I'm investigating 4 versus 2, so I'll pick 3 tokens. And I will cancel 1, I'll cancel the auto fail. So this is -2, it's X, and X is the number of barriers between your location and all connecting locations. And this is -1 for each location to the east of your location. This is east, so it's 0. So this resolves into -2, which is enough, so we get this clue. And that is our turn, no enemies. We go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get the Spectral Razor, and we gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. And as always, I forgot to add the Bless token to the back at the end of the round. Okay, we'll add a Doom to the agenda. The first encounter card is, and I might as well say that there are a lot of deep one enemies in this deck, so hopefully we don't run into any of them too quickly. We get the Dreams of Relay. Put Dreams of Relay into play in your threat area. You get -1 willpower and -1 sanity. Test willpower 3. If you succeed, discard Dreams of Relay. Okay, so that doesn't affect us yet. First action. I think we will just move to the Innsmouth Harbor. I can't get rid of these barriers yet. So let's see. The Innsmouth Harbor has 1 shroud and 1 clue. After you enter this location, move to the house of the on the water street. 2 double action parlay. Remove 1 barrier between this location and the connecting location. I think I will try my luck and use the trigger ability to move with a free action here. So house on the water street has 2 shroud and 1 clue. Forced after this location is revealed, randomly choose 1 of the set aside face down keys and place it on this location without looking at it. Free triggered ability, choose and discard 1 card from your hand. Parlay, remove 1 barrier between this location and the connecting location. Okay, so by discarding a card we could get that barrier removed. So we add a clue, and I'll just pick 1 key token randomly there. Second action, I think I'll just try to investigate. I'm investigate. Oh yeah, and there's 1 clue here. I'm using Olive. The objective here is to use 6th sense so that I will hit a special token so that I can investigate the Innsmouth Harbor instead of the my current location. So I can just nab that clue and don't have to move back. So we grab 3 location, 3 tokens. So let's see what we get with the bless token. Okay, so it's a minus one. Okay, so this is basically a three. Okay, so I could this is a zero and this is a minus one, but it's a plus three, so minus two is too much. I have only willpower three because of the dreams of Rillem, so I have to keep this, so I will we don't pick this one. Oh, actually here. Okay, so let's get these back. So basically this is a minus zero. This is a minus one. But I will opt to investigate here. So I'll actually do this. So these get returned in the bag. We don't use them. And we don't get the bonuses from them. And I will discard this. So we succeeded investigating here, and last action we'll do sixth sense again. I'll try to investigate here. So three versus two, and it's a zero. So we grab this clue too, and now we get this key that's here. And let's see, I think we can discard clairvoyance, so we remove this barrier, so we can next turn move here. Okay, no enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get David Renfield, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn, let's go to the next turn. And again, I forgot to add the bless token at the end of the round. We add a doom to the agenda. Oh, the doom threshold is 6, by the way. First encounter card is Riptide. Revelation, if your location is unflooded, Riptide can search. Otherwise, test the agility 3, or instead, if your location is fully flooded. If you fail, choose and discard one asset you control. If you cannot lose one resource for each point you failed by instead. Okay. Do we have anything? Well, this is quite unpleasant. We really don't want to lose Ollie McBride or the Sixth Sense. Especially now that we got rid of the clairvoyance. So I think I'll have to use Ollie. And pick three, hoping to hit a bless token. So I'm testing three versus three. Okay, at least we... this is a minus three. If you fail, choose a connecting location with no barriers between it and your location, personal barrier between. Okay, let's see where the bless token ends up. It's a zero. Okay, so we definitely pick this. This is plus two. And we can't pick this. This is a minus three, so I think we are failing. No way around it. I'm testing three versus three, so I can't succeed, so I will actually use the Sacred Covenant to put this back into the bag. I'll pick the minus four, so this goes into the bag. We fail by four, and I'll have to discard one asset I control, and it's unfortunately Olive. We can't get rid of the clairvoyance, unfortunately. Well, that's a shame. Nothing we can do about that. let's start our investigation phase. First action, we'll move to the Marsh Refinery. It's a three-shroud location with one clue. Pre-triggered ability, if you control one or more keys, move to a connecting location. Discard an asset you control, parlay, remove one barrier between this location and the connecting location. I think we won't waste our time here. I'll just use the pre-triggered ability to move here because I control a key. Okay, so we get the Fifth Street Bridge. There's two clues. And Fifth Street Bridge gets plus one shroud for each barrier between it and any connected location. Action, add two curse tokens to the chaos bag. Parlay, remove one barrier between this location and connecting location. I think I'll play down David Grenfield. I'll place one doom on David and I'll exhaust David to get one resource. This is just to boost my willpower. And I'll spend two clues. No, I'll move down here. This seems like a hard place to... we could try to get the clues to get the victory point. I'll actually do that. So, last action. First, I think... last action we will investigate, and I'm investigating 4 versus 4. Have nothing good to commit to this test, so... we get a blessed token. We are up by 2. And we get a cultist, which is -2 if you fail. Move to a connecting locations to the east, so where we succeed, and this goes away. We grab one clue, and that is that. No enemies, we go to upkeep. We draw Rite of Sanctification, and we gain one resource. And we'll add one bless token to the bag at the end of the round. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 4 doom of 6. The encounter card for this turn is Inundated. It's a hazard. Revelation, place one barrier between this location and each connecting location with no barriers between them. If no barriers are placed by this effect, Inundated gains search. So, we get a barrier here and here. Okay, well, I think we'll remove those barriers and investigate and stop moving. But before that, I'll play down Rite of Sanctification. And I will place 2 blessed tokens there, actually 3. So we are sealing blessed tokens here, which we can use to make other cards cheaper. And I think 3 is enough. We don't want to go overboard with this. Second action, I think I will... Well, actually, it's not an action. I think we'll just do this action twice. No, I think I'll risk it and I'll do an action to get rid of one barrier and place 2 curse tokens in the back. I think I need to save a bit of these clues for later. Yeah, and this is a free trigger ability. We remove the last barrier here. And last action, I actually try to get this clue, and the shroud is now 2, and I'm 4. Actually, before that, I'll just get one resource with David Renfield. But yeah, this... I think this is not exhausted. So we are investigating 4 versus 2. It's a minus 1. So we grab this clue. And that is our turn. No enemies. We go to upkeep. We draw a card. We get the ward of protection. And we gain 1 resource. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Oh yeah, and it's ready, David. We are at 5 doom of 6. The encounter card for this turn is 30 block calls. Test intellect 3. If you succeed, either take 1 damage or put further locations in play next to the gender deck. If you fail, do both. Investigators cannot parlay. At the end of the round, discard 1 copy of further locations from play as once per round. So I think we... I think that's fine. We'll just test it. I'm testing 2 versus 3. It's a minus 2. I'll take 1 damage on David Renfield, and this goes here. So we can't parlay. Okay. Let's see. I think first action, just to be sure, I'll use 1. Oh yeah, and we forgot to add a blessed token to the back at the end of the round. Last turn. So I'll get an resource with David, and we'll play the blessed blade, and I'll exhaust this. So it cost 1. 2 less, then I think I'll move here. Okay, so we got the Innsmouth Square. It's a forced location with 1 clue. Forced, after this location is revealed, spawn the set aside Innsmouth Shoggoth at this location, exhausted. Okay, and action parlay, move 1 barrier between this location and a connecting location, so it is between this location and a different connecting location. A free trigger the ability if the investigators control 2 or more keys as a group parlay, read flashback 5 in the campaign guide. Okay. So we get the Innsmouth Shoggoth. I'll just place it here. Let's see. Innsmouth Shoggoth is a 3 fight, 6 health, and 2 evade monster Shoggoth Elite. Hunter Massive. Innsmouth Shoggoth gets plus 2 health, so it has 6 health. When Innsmouth Shoggoth moves via its Hunter keyword, it ignores all barriers. Force, after Innsmouth Shoggoth moves, remove each barrier it moved through. So we'll just mark it. So, and it came plain exhausted. Okay, and there's 1 clue here. I think we don't want to stay here and find out what happens. So I think I'll run up to the new church green. Forced, after this location is revealed, randomly choose 1 of the set aside face down keys and place it on this location without looking at it. Action, if there are no clues on this location, parlay, remove 1 barrier between this location and a connecting location. Okay, and 1 clue here. Okay. And That is our turn. So are we ready our cards? Actually, I'll take one extra aura on David because we're in the witching hour, by the way. So I'll gain one more resource when I exhaust David. So that is the investigation phase, enemy phase. Nothing happens. Upkeep this ready. Everything else ready. This gets discarded, and we add one less token to the bag. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. So we remove all doom. And we advance the agenda, chased by the deep ones. So increase the flood level of each coastal location. Basically this, just move here, and these become fully flooded. Shuffle each set aside Ravager from the deep and young deep one enemy into the encounter deck along with the encounter discard pile. Then we have the Restless Tide agenda. Again, the only thing noteworthy is forced when your turn ends, if you are a fully flooded location, take one damage and one horror. So it gets worse, and the Doom threshold is 5. Okay, and we still need to take an encounter card, and it is Suzuki. It's a peril revelation. You must decide just one. Each investigator loses 3 resources. Each investigator takes 2 horror, or place 1 doom on the current agenda. This effect can cause the current agenda to advance. I think we can lose 3 resources. We have plenty of resources, and David will give us more. I'll add, we'll go to the investigation phase. I'll add a doom on David and exhaust David. We'll gain 1 resource. And first action, I think I will just investigate. Okay. So we basically can use, if we hit a special symbol, we can clear this location. Hopefully we do. Oh yeah, and there should be one random clue here, a random key here. So let's place that there before we forget. So, investigating 4 versus 3, and we hit a plus, and we hit a minus 3, but this is also that we can pick a different location, so we won't return plus. We pick this clue from here, and this gets removed. Second action, I'll investigate again. I think this time I'll commit the Ward of Protection so that we have a better chance at succeeding. We are investigating 5 or 3, and it's a minus 1, so we get this clue. Then we get this key, we get a green key. Then, if there are no clues on this location, parlay, remove one barrier between this location and the connecting location. I think we don't have time for that, so I'll just as a quick action remove one barrier here. Last action we'll move into the esoteric order of Dagon. So it's a fourth route location with one clue forced after this location is revealed. Randomly choose one of the set aside face down keys and place it on this location without looking at it. Double action parlay test intellect tree. If you succeed, remove one barrier between this location and the connecting location. So unfortunately, there are four barriers in between here and the last location we need to get to. So I think we need to find out another way. But yeah, we still need to put a random key here. So that is the investigation phase, enemy phase. This Shoggoth moves here. Actually, I think we have plenty of time. We could make it move here, so these barriers get removed. Next turn we could double back here. Maybe to get the flashback. Okay, let's try that out. No other enemies. We go to upkeep, we draw a card, we hit Promise of Power, and we gain one resource, and we'll add one bless token into the back. So we have four bless tokens in the back, two curse tokens in the back, and two bless tokens here. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom to the agenda. Counter card is another Dreams of Relay. So we lose one willpower and another sanity. I think we really need to start getting rid of those. I think the first action will be to get before we do anything, we'll get a resource with David. I think I'll try to get this done. So we'll add one curse token into the bag. We are testing willpower 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 versus 3. And we get a 0, so of course we succeed. We get rid of 1. I think we don't have time to try to get rid of the second. I think I will just try to investigate. I'm investigating 4 versus 4, so we really need to hit something good here. I think I'll have to commit that, so 5 versus 4. It's a minus 1, so we grab this clue. Then we get this key, and also this key. Last action, we move back to the nurtured screen. And then enemy phase, this hunt here. No more enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get the second wind, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. And again, we forgot to add one less token into the back. We add a doom. We are a 3 of 5 and count card is 30 blockouts. Test intellect 3. If you succeed, either take 1 damage or put 30 blockouts in play. I think we just test it, and before that, let's use David Renfield for the last time. So we'll get two resources. And it's a -2, so we fail. And David Renfield takes 1 damage. This goes here, so we can't parley. And we'll go to the investigation phase first. Oh yeah, unfortunately we can't parley, but I think that is okay. We'll move one. Next turn we can check that location out, or we could try to get rid of this. Let's move here. I'll try to get rid of this. So, let's see. First action I'll move, second action I'll try to get rid of this. Testing 4 versus 3. It's a bless token. So I'm 6 versus 3. -2. So 4 versus 3. And another bless. 6 versus 3. Oh, this is getting ridiculous. So skull is -2, so we pass, and all of these get removed, and we get rid of this one, Dreams of Relay, and I'll draw a card. So we get dreams drawn to the flame, which will help us immensely. That is the investigation phase. We go to the enemy phase. So this guy hunts here. We'll ready up. We'll draw a card. We get the ward of protection, and we gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Oh yeah, this goes away. We add 1 blessed token into the back. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom to the agenda. Encounter card for this turn is Inundated. So Revelation, place 1 barrier between this location and each location with no barriers between them. If no barriers are placed by this effect, Inundated gain search. I think we will ward of protection that. So I'll just take 1 horror, pay 1 resource, and this never happened because we want to be able to move. Then I think we will do the fast action parley. So we'll read flashback number 5. You are in the middle of a conversation with Joe Sergeant, the bus driver, but it must be several weeks earlier. The streets are not yet flooded, and all of the dilapidated ramshackle buildings still stand despite themselves. I told the outsider, Mr. Sergeant says, there ain't no buses out of Innsmouth today. But you're not looking for a bus out of Innsmouth. You explain that you have a proposition for Mr. Sergeant. He probes the streets for eavesdroppers before answering. What kind of proposition? You know you aren't going to get through to Mr. Sergeant with a moral argument, so you appeal to his material desires instead, offering a sizable sum of money in exchange for his assistance. After returning from Devil Reef, you found Innsmouth to be even less hospitable than normal. You are watched everywhere you go, simply traveling on foot but puts you in danger. So you need me to ferry you around like a chauffeur, that's it. Mr. Sergeant waits his opinion momentarily, then shakes your hand. I can do that. In your campaign log, under memories recovered, record deal with Joe Sargent. Put the set aside Joe Sargent asset into play under the control of an investigator at Innsmouth Square. So we get this story asset. So Joe Sargent. Joe Sargent is an ally hybrid. Uses 3 tickets. Paused when Joe Sargent leaves play, remove him from the game. Fast action. Spend 1 ticket. Move to a connecting location that is not fully flooded. Just put Joe here, and we'll put. Well, I'll use the resources. So there are 3 tickets on Joe. And okay. Then first action, I think we'll just move to the First National grocery. Actually, let's use Joe. So I'll spend 1 ticket, we'll move here, First National grocery. It's a 3 shroud location with 2 clues forced. After you enter this location from a connecting location, place 1 barrier between both locations. Action parlay, test your lowest skill. 2, if you succeed, remove 1 barrier between this location and connecting location. I think we could just take a risk here. Grab these clues. So we still haven't used any actions. So I'll take a risk, I'll draw onto the flame. So we'll get an encounter card. And it is a deep one assault. Disengage from each deep one enemy at your location. Each deep one enemy at your location and each connecting location engages you. If no enemies engage you for this effect, search the encounter deck and discard a pile for a deep one enemy. Spawn it engage with you and shuffle the encounter deck. So let's see. I think we could take the Ravager from the deep or the deep one bull. I think deep one bull is much more easier because that one doesn't hunt, and I will be trying to not to fight any of the other deep ones. So we grab these clues. So that is another victory point for us, which is really good. We'll shuffle the encounter deck. I'll place the deep one bull. Just put it here. It's engaged with us. And second action. Well, second action, I'll play the sword cane. So the sword cane can be played without attacks of opportunity, and I'll actually exhaust this and spend 1 here, so it's 3. Then after sword cane enters play, immediately trigger its action ability without paying its cost, so we don't have to exhaust it, and we can fight and or evade, and I'll use willpower instead of agility to evade deep one bull. So I'm evading 4 versus 2. So we get a less token. We are 6 versus 2. And it's a plus 1. So I will use Sacred Covenant to return this into the bag so we don't waste it. And this bull is evaded. And I'll spend another ticket from Joe Sargent. We'll move to Gilman's house. So it has 3 shroud, 2 clues forced. After this location is revealed, randomly choose 1 of the set aside face down keys and place it on this location without looking at it. Action parlay, test strength or agility 2. If you succeed, remove 1 barrier from this location and a connected location. And I think I'll just ignore this location. We really want to. We'll just spend 2 clues as a fast action to remove this barrier. and the last ticket from Joe to move to Sorbonne Alley. And it's a 4-star location with 2 clues, parlay test, willpower 1 per investigator, so it's willpower 1. If you succeed, remove 1 barrier from this location and the connecting location. Fast triggered ability, if the investigators control 7 keys as a group, parlay, read flashback 7 in the campaign guide. Well, we only have 4, so... oh yeah, we need to place one. Okay, we need to randomize this because I accidentally flipped it over. Okay, so one goes here. Oh yeah, actually I think I placed one here. Oh yeah, no clues are added here. Getting ahead of myself. But... Two clues here. I think we just try to get out. We already have 3 victory points, and this guy is hunting us, so we shouldn't risk it. Yeah, I think I'll try to investigate here once. If we get lucky, we can try to get the second clue next turn. So, 4 versus 4. A curse token. Well, at least that's out of the bag then. So we're behind by 2. We get a blessed token. So we're even again. And it's a skull, so it's a -4. So this... we fail. Actually... Yeah, we still fail, we can't even investigate there. So that is our turn. Yeah, this should be somewhere here. This guy hunts here. No other enemies. We ready up. Draw a card. We get another 6 cents and we gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 4 doom of 5. Encounter card. It's emerging deep one. It is a hunter revelation. Emerging deep one enters play exhausted and unengaged unless its location is fully flooded. Pause after emerging deep one engages you. If your location is flooded, it attacks you. So it comes into play, but it is exhausted because we are not at a flooded location, so I'll just place it here. Yeah, this should have read it. So, I think first action will just try to investigate. I'm investigating. Oh yeah, we forgot to add another blessed token at the end of the round. I just investigate 4 versus 4. Have nothing to commit to the test. Auto fail. Let's investigate again. 4 versus 4. It's a -1. I think we'll just move to the little bookshop. So, little bookshop is a 3-shot location with 1 clue. Double action, draw the top card of the encounter deck, parlay, remove 1 barrier between this location and a connecting location. Free triggered action, if the investigators control 5 or more keys as a group, parlay, read flashback 6 in the campaign guide. So we unfortunately have only 4 keys. And I think we just try to get out next turn, so I won't spend any clues. Because if we get the treachery that adds barriers, we basically waste clues. So I think I'll just end my investigation phase here. I'll do the enemy phase. So this guy moves here. And upkeep, this guy readies. We draw a card. We get drawn to the flame. Well, a bit late, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Yeah, add one bless token to the back. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We advance the agenda. So, pursued by townsfolk. So, increase the flood level of each midtown location. These are midtown, so basically we'll move these here. Also, these are coastal and midtown, so they are fully flooded. And these are partially flooded. Spawn the set aside angry mob at Innsmouth Square. Randomly choose one of the set aside face down keys and place it on angry mob without looking at it. So we get the angry mob. Angry mob is 3 fight, 4 health, 3 evade, humanoid elite, hunter massive, retaliate. Angry mob gets plus 4 health per investigator. Angry mob cannot make attacks of opportunity. And there is one key there. I think we are just going to get out while we can. Then we have the flooded streets. So when your turn ends, if you are at a fully flooded location, take one damage, one horror, and discard one card at random from your hand. So it's getting worse. Then we get an encounter card. And it is titled Alignment, Peril, Revelation. Choose a location where there is at least one investigator. Increase that location flood level. Each investigator at that location at the chosen location takes one damage. If the chosen location's flood level is not increased by this effect, title alignment gets searched. So luckily we can raise the level here, and I'll take one damage on myself. So investigation phase, fast triggered action. I'll remove one barrier from here. First action, we'll move to the rail road station. It's a one-shot location with zero clues. Forced, after you enter this location, if it is flooded, test agility 2. If you fail, take one damage. Action resign, you escape the submerged town. So, second action, we will resign. And that is that scenario. Let's see the resolution. So, through the labyrinth, so object get to the railway station. If each surviving investigator has resigned, advance out of the town. After hours of fleeing, sneaking and hiding, you finally reach the abandoned railway station on the western edge of Innsmouth. The moment you see the two automobiles parked by the trucks, you break into a run. You're more than happy to leave this awful place behind. In your campaign log record, the investigators made it safely to the to their vehicles. Resolution 1. Resolution 1. So I'll just read the resolution. Basically, we are getting another flashback at the end of this, and we decide to do stuff. So let's see. Each investigator earns experience equal to the victory X value of each card in the victory display. So it is 3. Let's see if I'm missing anything. No. The 3 locations we found. Check campaign log if the investigators made it safely to their vehicles. Each investigator records 2 additional experience under unspent experience. So, we get 5 experience and we proceed to scenario 4, Devil Reef. And all of the experience went under the unspent experience, and we still can't spend that experience, so we'll see. Probably we'll have to play the next scenario before we can spend the experience, but we'll see when that Mythos Pack comes out. This went better than I expected. I really like the Sacred Covenant on System Mary. But yeah, thanks for watching, and until next time.